Hi friends, this is Video Lancer. In this video, I will show you a simple way to create these popular distortion zoom transitions. So let's start. Create a new composition and import your footages into it. Create an adjustment layer. Cut the adjustment layer at the junction between two footages. The first part of the adjustment layer will be responsible for the beginning of the transition. The second is for the ending. So let's call these layers in and out, respectively. Use transform effect for the in layer and animate parameter scale from 100 to 300%. Now smooth the animation a little in Graph Editor, so that speed could increase closer to the junction. Make the similar animation for out layer. Set 25% for scale value near the junction and 100% for the final key. Smooth the graph so that the animation slow down at the end. To fill the blank space that appeared here, use motion tile effect and increase values for output. Now let's add motion blur. Switch off a checkbox in transform effect and increased value of shutter angle up to maximum. A leaping appeared at the junction. To fix this, simply slide this key one frame forward. This stare effect was caused by the limits in 16 samples per a frame for transform effect. In order to fix it, just add extra smoothing on problematic clips. It can be done by CC radial blur effect. It's ready. At this stage, the transition is already looking good, but we'll go on. Add optics compensation effect on the in layer. Switch on checkbox reverse lens distortion. For parameter FOV, set animation values from 0 to 160. Then copy optics compensation effect to the out layer. Here you should switch on the checkbox optimal pixels. For parameter FOV, set animation values from 160 to 0. Then smooth the animation in Graph Editor. If it is necessary, you can correct the animation for scale in order it could match distorting effect maximally well. You can add intermediate keys in order to smooth the animation better, closer to the ending. Now let's add chromatic aberrations. I won't show in detail how to create them. You can see this in my previous video overviews. I'll just add a ready preset. animate the shift parameter in the preset settings. Peak should be at the junction of the transition. It is ready. It looks very cool, but to complete the transition, we need to add the option to change zoom target. Add a new null object and call it target control. Go to settings of chromatic aberrations and click on optic center while holding down the alt key. Now link these parameters to position of target control layer. Copy this expression into other effects that have point control. This is the anchor point and position of transform effect, center of optics compensation effect, and CC radial blur. It is ready. And finally, let's add a sound effect. Done. That is all. If you like similar effects, you can get hundreds of similar transitions ready for use. They are PowerZoom, Elastic, Diamond, Lens, and others. All the links are in the description. I do hope this video tutorial was useful for you. Next time, I will show you how to create the similar zoom transition directly in Premiere Pro. Subscribe to not miss. This was Video Lancer. So long.